Students, welcome back. Let's continue with your subject computer graphics. The next topic is input and output devices. I know everyone is aware of the input and output devices. So just recall what are the input devices and what are the output devices. So let me start. The input devices are the hardware that is used to transfer input to the computer. So whatever we are giving instructions to the computer, so through which device we are giving instructions to the computer, that devices we call it as an input devices. So those are the hardware parts. So the input devices or the hardware that is used to transfer input to the computer. The data can be in the form of a text, graphics or sound. So you can send the input in the form of anything. The text, if you want to text, send the text message to the computer, you need to type the user keyboard, and the graphics, sound, microphone. So those are all the input devices. And the output devices is a display data from memory to the of the computer. And coming to the output devices we call it as a display. So it is a what it is going to display, it is going to display the data. So from where it gets the data? From memory in the computer. In the computer, you are having the memory. From the memory, it takes the data and displays on the screen. So whatever you are able to see, that is an output devices. The output can be a text, numeric data, line, polygon, and even the other object also. So input that you are giving, that input is giving with the help of input devices. That input devices sending the information to the CPU and the memory. So after performing the operations, the CPU is going to process the data which is taken from the memory, and that will be displayed to the output devices. So after in the output devices, we are getting the output. So that result of processing the human acceptable form means whatever we are able to understand, in that format the output devices sends the data to the output, means as an output. Okay, so this is an input and output. Let me show you some of the input devices. Some of the input devices are the keyboard, mouse, trackball, spaceball, joystick, voice recognition, image scanner, touch screen, digitizer, light paint. I know you all you already know all these concepts. So just let me recall, okay, a little bit. So what is a keyboard? You already know the keyboard, which is the most common used input devices. It's having total 101 keys that are present in your keyboards. Okay, so this is the most common used input devices. And next is a mouse. Mouse is, you call it as a pointing device. It is pointing device. So, and the one thing that you have to remember, that it cannot be used to enter the text. It's just only pointing. It's just a cursor, the pointing device. And the trackball. The trackball is also a pointing devices. It is also a pointing device, similar to the mouse. It's just similar to the mouse, but here this is mainly used in the notebooks or laptop computers instead of the mouse. Suppose if you don't have instead of the mouse, we can use this trackball. Next is a spaceball. Spaceball is similar to that of trackball, but it can move in six directions. The spaceball can move in six directions, whereas the trackball is move only in two directions. So it is moving only two directions, but spaceball is moved in six directions. So then where we use this spaceball? So I said trackball can be used in the notebooks or in laptops instead of the mouse. And where we use this spaceball? This spaceball can be used for the 3D positioning of objects. In the 3D environment, we can use a spaceball because we it supposes it can move in six directions, and it is applicable in the CAD applications, that is the computer aided design applications, and it is also used in the animations. Next is a joystick. Joystick is also a pointing devices which is used to change the cursor position on monitor screens, and it can change all the four directions. So it will be four directions. Joystick can be used in four directions. Space is six direction, and track is only in two directions. And where we use this joystick? The joysticks can be used in CAD designing, and even the playing of computer games, you can use the joystick. you know the voice recognition. So with the help of that microphone, the voice can be recognized and it will be performed. The operations, image scanner. So what it will just print this message on the paper, images or the text, whatever it may be, that can be print on the paper. So you just place that on the image scanner and that will be saved on the system. Okay. And the touch screen. So that is one of the input devices, digitizer, and even the light pen. The light pen is similar to a pen, which is a pointing device which is used to select the displayed menu item or even draw the pictures on the monitor. So these are all the different input devices. And coming to the output devices I already said, which accepts data from computer. Output devices accept data from computer. Okay. And after accepting the data from computer and translates them into a form which the human can understand by users. So that is the output devices. So the output devices are printers, or even you can call the plotters. So printers is used to print the data on paper, whereas the plotters or the special type of output devices, it is suitable for architecture planning or even the CAD applications. Okay, so this is about the input and output devices. Thank you.